What's up, guys? I'm Jeff, the founder of Worldwide Cyclery, and today we're going to do a little comparison of the SRAM Eagle drivetrains, NX, GX, X01, and XX1. What's the difference between these things, other than price point, as you probably already know? Let's talk about it. All right, so the SRAM Eagle drivetrain, if you're watching this video, you're probably pretty familiar with what it is. It's SRAM's 1x12 drivetrain, and it's been out for, I think, a couple years now or a few years now. Pretty darn amazing drivetrain. It's been on a ton of different bikes that we've seen and just great. So a lot of people have been asking us questions about it. SRAM has been sort of slowly releasing other models. When they released XX1, I think they did XX1 at the same time. A little while after, they did GX, and then just recently they did NX. So NX, I don't even think is for sale just yet, but it's been released and it's out in the wild, and I think it'll be coming to retail shelves around September or so. All these drivetrains, obviously, you know, like you have a lot of choices in the mountain bike world, the biggest difference is price point. So you're probably already familiar with that. To go over the price point, the NX for the 5-piece Grupo, what you're looking at right there, $375. Step up to the GX, $510. X01, pretty big jump here, $1,169, and the XX1 is at $1,433. So the prices fluctuate a little bit on these things, but that's the general pricing difference on there. And to talk about some of the differences, they're pretty darn similar. So GX to XX1, all three of those cassettes use an XD driver body, and the cassette has a 10 to 50 range on it. That is where the NX is a bit different. The NX uses a Shimano freehub body, and it's got an 11 to 50 range on the cassette. So that's a pretty big difference, because if you have a Shimano freehub body, NX is going to be a lot easier drivetrain to upgrade to. So there's going to be a link below in the description that links you to the video we did about the release of NX and go more into detail on that specific drivetrain. But that one does have a key difference there, with the cassette having a little bit different range and using a Shimano freehub body versus the XD freehub body. So aside from that and the price points, what really is the difference here? I mean, especially when you see that price point change so much, what are you getting when you spend more money? Obvious differences from NX and GX, both of those cranks are aluminum, and X01 and XX1 are carbon cranks. So that's why the price point jumps a ton. A carbon crank is much lighter, stiffer, and it's more expensive to manufacture. So that's why the price point jumps up so drastically for these two drivetrains. Aside from that, what else are you getting, right? When you're going from this direction to this direction, a lot of it really does boil back down to weight. So in the mountain bike world, you're probably familiar with at this point, but a lot of the time, the more money you spend, the lighter your bike gets. And that is as true as it gets with these drivetrains and with pretty much any other drivetrain out there. So the weight of the actual drivetrains obviously is going to be heavier on the cheaper side and lighter on the more expensive side. And it kind of, you know, is going to ramp as you might imagine. The key difference other than weight and price point, in my opinion, is kind of feel. All of these things shift absolutely perfect. I think we've sort of hit a level in the world of mountain bike drivetrains where they all shift really, really well. And what I mean by that is, even if you're under a little bit of load, you're just clicking through the gears, if you install any of these drivetrains correctly, they're gonna shift buttery smooth and work absolutely great. The little tiny differences that you might notice, at least for me, when I hop on a bike with each one of these, and I've spent a little bit of time, well, significant time on some drivetrains and a little bit on NX since it's so new, not like extensive time, but it's kind of just like any cheaper drivetrain versus a more expensive drivetrain. So sort of that crisp, stiff feel, that's what you lose a little bit. So it still shifts perfect, but it's just little things like the flex in the lever of the actual shifter, or the flex in the cranks, little things like that. It just kind of feels a little bit cheaper. It's really hard to explain because they're both shifting perfect, right? But it just feels a little cheaper. And because the materials are not quite as nice, they're not quite as stiff, they're not quite as, you know, CNC'd out on the cheaper end as they are on the higher end. So, you know, that's kind of something that you'll notice if you ride these things. That might be like me just being crazy and being really aware of that feeling, but I think anyone could kind of tell it. If you rode NX and then you rode a bike with XX1, you'd feel that difference. You know, they both shift perfectly smooth, but that sort of flexy, cheapy feel is a little more noticeable on NX, and rightfully so. I mean, it's way, way cheaper. So still works perfect, but with that price point comes some additional weight and a little flex. And there's other little things too as far as adjustments, and a lot of that boils back down to the shifters. So the shifters on the X01 and the XX1 have this adjustment here where you can sort of move in or out the actual shift lever to your preference, how far you want that thing in or out. That's a pretty cool adjustment. GX is lacking that, as well as NX. So that's a tiny little adjustment that some people might care about, some people might not, but you do get it on this end of the table and not that end of the table. Other than that, you know, we'll talk a little bit about weights and specifics. All these drivetrains are great, and whatever fits your budget, you're going to be stoked with these things. They all work amazing, and you really can't go wrong with any of them. Just, you know, try it out. See if you're not on Eagle yet, see which one fits your price point, what might make sense for your bike, especially if you have a Shimano Freehub body and you're in that price point. NX might make a lot more sense. Other than that, let's get into some specs of the weights of these things. I actually spent the time to weigh all these grupos and parts individually. Of course, there is claimed weights from SRAM, but I wanted to see what my own gram scale said. As we talked about, the cheaper stuff being a little bit heavier, you can definitely see that here. So to start off weighing all of the group sets, NX came in at 2012, GX at 1,809, X01, 1,551, XX1, 1,541. So you can definitely see the differences there, and you can kind of see where those price points make the biggest difference. GX to X01 being a pretty significant drop, as well as NX to GX. Next up for the cassettes. Cassettes definitely make a huge difference in the overall weight of the grupos, as it's one of the heaviest parts within them, along with the cranks, of course. So for cassettes, NX, 588 grams, GX, 450 grams, X01, 357 grams, XX1, 364 grams. So pretty interesting there. Cassettes make a huge difference when it comes to how a grupo feels and shifts, and a lot of what changes the weight there are the materials that it's made out of and then the process that the whole thing is put together. Whether it's stamped and then pinned together or it's all CNC, the manufacturing process makes all of the difference when it comes to how much those things actually end up weighing. So next up for cranks, NX, 701 grams, GX, 630 grams, X01, 487 grams, XX1, 483 grams. Biggest thing you can notice there is the difference in weight between GX and X01. And that's because NX and GX have aluminum cranks, X01 and XX1 have carbon cranks. So of course, you're gonna shave a ton of weight with carbon cranks. And for derailleurs, NX, 341 grams, GX, 294 grams, X01, 282 grams, XX1, 270 grams. So no huge differences there, but you know, pretty clear. Things get lighter as they get more expensive and the materials get you know, more refined. Shifters are a little bit strange. Shifters, there's some more adjustability on the nicer shifters like the X01 and the XX1. A couple differences as far as the materials that the shifter caps are made out of and the bolts there, but weights, NX, 112 grams, GX, 122 grams, X01, 125 grams, XX1, 124 grams. As far as chains, there's not too much of a huge difference. What really matters is when you're looking at these group sets, what they actually weigh all together, the actual group set weights. But something to really keep in mind is the cross compatibility. So the coolest thing about Eagle is you can mix and match all of this stuff. So you can buy these as group sets, you can buy all the parts individually as well, and it's all cross compatible. So if you want to create something in your desired weight range and price point, you can pretty much pull that off. For example, if you wanted to do X01 parts, but you didn't want the carbon cranks, you could easily get GX cranks or NX cranks. Or if you wanted to do a GX grupo, but you have a Shimano Freehub body on your bike, so then you could just go with an NX cassette. So there is complete cross compatibility between all of these grupos, NX, GX, X01, and XX1. So keep that in mind when you're shopping for grupos. You can take it simple and just buy the whole group set, or you can mix and mash the way you want to. I'll parkour into this, baby. It's a bunch of freaking things. It'll be fine. Do anything for the YouTube. We ready? You got the other cameras filming? You good?
Do it.
I'm not even talking. It's nothing, dude. 150 pounds of rushing steel. I went right through those packing pillows. Thank you guys for watching. I made a complete mess weighing all this stuff. Got all the single grams just for you guys. Hit that subscribe button. Let us know which drivetrain do you use. Which one do you think is best? See you in the next one.